Hey cadets. Even if you are someone who doesn't really keep up with the crypto sector, you've probably heard of Ethereum at least once. This crypto giant has been trending throughout the year along with Elon Musk's Dogecoin and the rest of crypto Twitter's Bitcoin maxis. For all the Ethereans, something big is on the way. That's right, it's Ethereum 2.0. The implementation of this long-awaited major upgrade started on December 1st, 2020, and it is going to revolutionize blockchain technology forever. Ethereum's current systems will be getting a complete overhaul with the 2.0 version, with the aim of making the existing Ethereum public mainnet more powerful, more scalable, greener, more sustainable, and more secure. Whew, that's quite a lot. But wait, there's more. From a user's perspective, the most important thing is that there will be a ton of opportunities to earn a great passive income on your ETH investments through staking. However, we have to keep in mind that this upgrade is not an act of snapping fingers like Thanos to make the previous version of Ethereum disappear. The process of changing will be gradual and require a lot of development and patience. In this video, we will be trying to make the concept of ETH 2.0 as understandable as possible so you can explain this concept to anybody in simple terms. Hey, you might even impress your next door crush who just might be a crypto nerd. Hey, you never know. So, are we ready to explore the world of Ethereum 2.0? I'm Captain Crypto and welcome to Cryptonauts.
Cryptonauts.
The best way to figure out Ethereum 2.0 is by understanding how it differs from its predecessor. Originally, Ethereum operates on the proof of work consensus mechanism. It is the same mechanism that Bitcoin currently uses at the moment. However, this system is far from perfect as there are three major flaws associated with it. Number one, it consumes a lot of energy to validate transactions and keep the network secure. 717,797 US households could be powered by the energy expended on validating the Ethereum network for a single day. Number two, it's way too slow. The current version of Ethereum can process around 15 transactions per second, which is miles behind Visa that can process a massive 65,000 transactions per second. Number three, it is a bit centralized. Large crypto miners build their facilities in places where the electricity is cheap. As an example, four mining pools, of which the majority were previously located in China, controlled more than 50% of the total Bitcoin mining power. Learn more about the differences between proof of work and proof of stake by clicking right here. Now that we've established the main problems that hold Ethereum back from reaching its goals, we can move on to the solutions. But every story has a hero, and this is where the Ethereum 2.0 development program swoops in to save the day. The upgrades to scalability, security, and sustainability from Ethereum 2.0 come from the swap to the proof of stake mechanism. However, there is one more thing that makes this upgrade complete, and that is sharding. So what is sharding and how does it solve the problem? Well, think of a glass jar. If I accidentally drop it on the floor, it breaks into hundreds and thousands of shards. In a similar way, the Ethereum blockchain can be split into several shards. Shard chains split the Ethereum blockchain and divide the data processing responsibility among multiple nodes instead of a single node. As a result, sharding makes it possible for transactions to be processed in parallel rather than consecutively. This makes Ethereum capable of executing thousands of transactions per second. So, this amazing duo of POS and shard chains are the two most important things about Ethereum 2.0. Alright, now let's move on to the next part, the timeline. For those who are wondering if Ethereum 2.0 has launched yet, the answer is both yes and no. Ethereum 2.0 is going to be a multi-phase rollout starting with phase 0 and ending at phase 3. Phase 0 already kickstarted on December 1st, 2020, but a full upgrade rollout might take 2 or 3 years. One important thing to keep in mind here is that Ethereum 2.0 will launch as a separate network. What this means is that Ethereum 1.0 will not be instantly flushed out, but will coexist in parallel with the Ethereum 2.0 development phase. Let's take a closer look at the separate phases of the upgrade. Phase 0. The Ethereum 2.0 launch was officially set into motion with the Phase 0 deployment on December 1st, 2020. The objective of this phase is to allow the seamless migration of validators from a proof-of-work-based Ethereum to a proof-of-stake-based Ethereum network with the help of the Beacon Chain. The Beacon Chain acts like a bridge that makes all of this possible. The new POS mechanism called Casper will replace the current proof-of-work engine in Ethereum 2.0. Casper will be delivered via the Beacon Chain, which will be the system chain of Ethereum 2.0. We should also keep in mind that the Beacon Chain doesn't change the Ethereum you use today. You can still send ETH to a friend, swap tokens on MetaMask or Uniswap, and continue playing those blockchain games that you so dearly love. Phase 1. With the Beacon Chain and its POS system running smoothly, Phase 1 will activate Ethereum 2.0's primary scaling solution, sharding. As we previously mentioned, sharding will multiply the network's throughput and speed. The 64 POS shards that will be deployed in this phase will boost the throughput 64 times. Phase 1.5. Ethereum 2.0 acts as a separate network from Ethereum up until the rollout of Phase 1.5. Once the docking is done, the transfers of ETH made from Ethereum to Ethereum 2.0 would become impossible to reverse, while the dApps built on one network will not exist in the other. This phase signifies the merge of Ethereum 1.0 and Ethereum 2.0. Phase 2 represents the activation of the functionality for dApp deployment natively on Ethereum 2.0. Once communication between all 64 shards and the Beacon Chain is fully tested, Phase 2 will enable users to store and deploy new smart contract data on any of the shards in the Ethereum 2.0 network. Out of all the previous phases we discussed, Phase 3 is the least defined. In the words of Vitalik Buterin, this phase is reserved for other stuff that we want to add down the line. This could mean adding more shards to the Ethereum 2.0 network or new cryptographic technologies such as zero-knowledge, scalable, transparent arguments of knowledge, ZK Snarks. One of the most exciting opportunities with Ethereum 2.0 is the ability to earn passive income by staking your ETH. The good thing here is that staking eliminates the need for expensive hardware and greatly reduces the entry barrier to the staking game. You can run a validator node with just three things: a decent laptop, 32 ETH, and a good internet connection. For those that think 32 ETH does not fit in their pocket size, no need to fret. There are already several staking pools and services that make participation possible for everyone, regardless of the size of your holdings. In order to earn staking rewards on Ethereum 2.0, you will need to lock your ETH holdings. The purpose of this is to make sure that you participate in the network as an honest validator. If you want to learn more about staking on Ethereum 2.0, you can check out the Ethereum Launchpad, which will take you through the process of setting up a validator node in a step-by-step fashion. Just hit the URL in your favorite browser. With that being said, be mindful of one thing. Once you migrate your Ether into Ethereum 2.0, you won't be able to extract it back until Ethereum 1.0 and Ethereum 2.0 are merged together. So what do you say, fellow Cryptonauts? Are you going to stake your Ether right now, or possibly wait until the network finishes with the Ethereum 2.0 development? Or are you already staking your Ethereum? Let us know in the comments. And if you like the video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. As always, HODL, secure crypto, and may Satoshi and Vitalik be with you always.